Dame Arabia as a content editorial team player. And he's an AI enthusiast, apart from being an evangelist and a trainer. A lot of things.
Yeah.
And now you'll find out.
Where's my PPT? I did. I think
this one.
Are we? Good evening.
Good evening.
I would like to thank you for attending this event. Thank you, Dr. Jamal, my mom. Imran, where is Imran? Thank you. Actually, BIM is one of my favorite hobbies, let's say. But unfortunately, I feel nostalgic that people talking about BIM. I'm talking about something different than BIM. But for a change, today I'm going to talk about artificial intelligence intuition. I'm not going to talk much about artificial intelligence itself as much as the intuition of the artificial intelligence. Let me start with this. Do you have any idea in heaven or earth what is this? That's a Wei Qi. It's a 3,000 years old Chinese game called Wei Qi, which means Go, literally means Go game in China. It's been played by millions of people all over the globe. For the people that who believes that the globe is sphere, not flat, and strategies were developed by brilliant expertise all over the time to win this game. Wei Qi is a difficult game. It's much more difficult than chess is. Actually, Wei Qi is the most difficult board game ever, and doesn't rely only on strategies and experience. It also relies on intuition. And there's one specific reason for this. It's because the reason is there are just as much number of combinations of the game as the number of atoms of the known universe. It's just too much. Can you imagine this? It's just way too much for the number of combinations. This is getting me hypnotized. Let me get over it. Okay. You can take a diploma degree in this Wei Qi game because it doesn't measure only your way of playing. It measures your way of strategic thinking, and it measures your performance under pressure. Can you see? Shall I?
Yes.
I'll keep moving back and forth. And you can get hired, yes, with this diploma. In China, Japan, yes, because it measures how good you are in problem solving and strategic thinking. I want you to meet Mr. Li Sidol. He happened to be a winner of 18 world titles in this game. He is a 9-dan professional in the Q-dan ranking system. He is 9-dan means top of the line. He is a master on this. It's a very ancient ranking system, and he is widely considered as the greatest player of this game over the last decade. This brave chap has to play against a computer algorithm called AlphaGo that was designed to play this game. And fortunately, he lost the game. Well, I'm not happy because he lost the game, no. I'm happy because the algorithm won the game. He lost a 5-game match. Yeah, he lost a 5-game match in front of this computer algorithm. That was in last March 2016. And it was more than just a win. It was a complete disruption of the human ability, but it appeared, a human ability in analyzing strategic thinking and intuition. Yes, intuition, which was a complete human characteristic or a unique human privilege that is not anymore after this win. AlphaGo was intuitive enough to backfire from an early mistake in the game to cope up a recovery against Mr. AlphaGo. And it was brave enough to take the chance or the risk for 1 to 10,000 winning movement that was never ever recorded by any human in the history. It was taken by a machine that was intuitive enough. We knew something that's unknown to human. Yes. It's not working, yes it is. But how come? What do you think that made such a machine intuitive enough to win such a game that needs more than strategy, needs more than experience, it needs rather intuitive?
Intelligence.
Exactly, you might have guessed it right. Artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is not about smart programmers or great back-end developers anymore, no. It is self-learning, it assumes, adapts, predicts, it can get or find the typical and non-typical data patterns. Artificial intelligence is being supercharged by machine learning and deep learning. In machine learning, where the computer or artificial intelligence, the AI algorithm, start collecting data from giant blocks, we call big data, on the cloud, and they sequence similar patterns of data. They put them together and they kind interpolate or extrapolate the anticipation. And the infrastructure of this is deep learning. This is very interesting. Has anybody had any idea about deep learning?
I'm running away from it.
Hardly surprising. Okay.
Like DNA.
DNA.
More or less, Mr. Jan LeCun, who happened to be a scientist in what they call data science, he had developed some algorithm simulating the way human brain cells think and operate. He managed to do this, and he managed to make it in one layer. He worked on it from 1990 till 1998, and he stopped for hardware capability reasons. Back in 2006, after a couple of years, he was called back again by the European Development Center, better known as CERN, to re-inaugurate this project. And AlphaGo development is developed by a company called DeepMind, was acquired by Google back in 2014. And it consisted of 13 layers of ConvNets, what they call it, convolutional neural networks, or they just short it into CNN. It was 13 layers, remember this number, because you're gonna be shocked now. Okay, before playing against Mr. Lee Sedol, AlphaGo played against millions of people over the internet. You can play the game, by the way, you can play it online. And it has played against itself millions of times. It was allowed to play against itself millions of times. So it didn't play against Mr. Lee Sedol before. Never. And the game, or the AlphaGo AI algorithm, has developed itself and experience, intuition, and intelligence from playing with people and playing against herself. This is what happened after the winning. Professional players around the world play against AlphaGo to acquire knowledge and intelligence and skills they couldn't develop in the past 3,000 years. Mind you, this AlphaGo is just like 1 year old. Okay? By that time, meet Mr. Jan LeCun the Great. He's director of AI Research Facebook. Have you seen this name before? This face before? He's quite famous on AI research and stuff like that. He stated that Facebook AI algorithm is 100 layers deep by now. That the algorithm that detects the faces on the photos, it's 100 layers deep, not 13 layers deep like the one read by Mr. Lee Sedol. I have read a tweet for Mr. Mark Zuckerberg 2 weeks back that Facebook AI is going to prevent people who are trying to commit suicide on Facebook. I think Omar, he asked me about, what do you mean by this? Yeah. It's just deep. It was inaugurated back on last November, 26th, November 26th. It's just very deep. Convolutional neural networks are being adopted by all big players in the market, Google, Intel, Facebook, Twitter, you name them. And let's talk about applications. First application will be Google Translator. I understand that we as a human, we contribute to this Google Translator. However, there is in the back end some AI algorithm that says this fits where. So at the end, the AI controlling this. This is another augmented reality application where the AI itself, the algorithm, imprint the translation directly, and this works. I'm not talking about the translation itself. If you go into a Chinese website, it will offer you a translation into a language that you know. So how did this AI algorithm know that you know English or Arabic or whatever language you like? I'm not talking yet about the translation itself. So this is very interesting. Another application is the Google server cooling system. DeepMind itself, which was acquired, the company was acquired by Google. It managed to reduce the cooling power's consumption by 40%, maintaining the same level of cooling. We had to wait. I mean, we humans, we weren't there all the time. We couldn't make it until we reached to a point that human or artificial intelligence should do it. I've been talking about this almost all the time recently over social media, and I feel people like skeptical about artificial intelligence, that they are going to overcome and eliminate a human's brain. Well, I have good news for you, or maybe bad news. We are almost about to reach the point of time that we are having an artificial intelligence algorithm almost the same, has the same capabilities of the human brains. You can play, where is this, with the AI algorithm. You can give it a famous statue, and it will tell you easily where is this. I mean, everybody can do, like the Statue of Liberty or Jerusalem, or such a picture, which is, for me at least, has no information. I can't tell where is this, but AI can tell you. It can distinguish between a sand and another, a water and another, and a sky and another. Actually, I will share through the proper channels. We have a website that you can upload a photo, and it will pinpoint on the board where this photo was taken.
And it's mind-boggling. It is running out of my mind. How?
Don't ask me. It is there. Exactly. So these are other applications of artificial intelligence. Classifying white blood cells with deep learning and medical applications, features for age estimation, and satellite photo similar image search by Tera Pattern. This is the website I was talking about. And another application is describing a painting. If you can provide a picture, an image, or a painting to the AI algorithm, it can describe this painting for you. Like, for example, if you get a photo of a building, it can describe this building for you. More interestingly, it can paint a description for you. You can utter or say, communicate with this AI algorithm just verbally, it will start paint the description for you.
Paint the description?
Yes, sir.
Exactly, that's
the question. So let me end up with this. Our current clients and future challenges. Don't you think that our current clients would talk to future AI algorithms to get their designs done without having us intermeddling the whole process?
No.
Think about this. I have met robots myself, shake hands with robots, that they did the measurement, simulation of a bridge, 3D printing of steel bridge without a human interference. That was in 2016. Myself. Ladies and gentlemen, that was all for me. I wish you find it educational and entertaining. Thank you very much.
Entertaining. Come on.